校长、主任、各位老师和同学们，大家早安！欢迎收看《声风展话新闻》，我是主播向少俊，
我是主播林诗晴。
哎，少俊啊，这学期你有没有发现这学期我们来了一位外国老师啊？
当然有啊，这学期我们学校成为桃园市双语创新教学的示范学校喽，所以同学们就能有更多的机会去接触外国的文化了。
没错。大家有看到在我旁边这位年轻又可爱的外国老师吗？相信大家都一定很想认识他。那么我们就请老师跟大家自我介绍一下吧。
Yes, we'd love to know about our foreign teacher. She looks nice and pretty. Hello, teacher. Would you please introduce yourself to us?
Hello, everyone. My name is Jenna. I'm from the United States of America. My hometown is here, Jeffersonville, Indiana.
哇，原来Jenna老师是个美国人啊，而且她来自于印第安纳州。一听到这个名字，我就想到
One little, two little, three little Indians.
Thank you for the introduction, Teacher Jenna. Is it true your hometown founded by Indians?
Yes, it's true. And the state of Indiana looks like a boot. How cute is that?
真的长得很像靴子。我们台湾的形状就长得像一颗番薯了。我们可是以坚韧的番薯精神为傲呢。
Yeah, that's great. Okay, so I'm going to ask a few questions now. How long have you been in Taiwan? And what has impressed you the most so far?
Well, so far I've been in Taiwan for about 4 months. The food is delicious and the people are wonderful. I love the scenery. I love the mountains and the sea.
是的，我们的特色小吃，澎湖知名的蓝豆，以及处处充满人情味的台湾文化，的确是魅力四射啊。
Yes, it surely is, because of the Taoyuan City Bilingual School Program. Teacher Jenna has come to our school to teach the first graders. Would you please share your teaching and how you feel about the students?
Well, the students are all energetic and seem to be excited to learn. Although they're not familiar with the English language, I try to use different teaching techniques to help them better understand.
对啊，我一开始接触英语学习的时候也觉得很陌生，大概是因为使用的机会比较少吧。不过，随着网络时代吸收知识的趋势，英语就是他的语言了。因此，英语能力是很重要的。
That is so cool. As for me, I'm happy I have a nice English teacher.Who always teaches me English in a fun way. Therefore, will you tell us what you do to encourage the students to learn in an exciting way?
Well, I try to design fun activities to help the students be eager to learn.
对啊，上英文课最好玩的就是老师都会用游戏来进行活泼的英语教学。好想知道 Teacher Jenna 是怎么上课的，学校里的一年级弟弟妹妹们一定学得很开心。
To know about your fun activities. So, Teacher Jenna, would you please share one activity for everyone?
Well, recently I taught a topic about bubbles. Within the unit, the students made bubble solution, learning the difference between hot and cold water. The students had the opportunity to physically mix the hot or cold water before blowing the bubbles.
制作泡泡，我小时候也有做过哦，就是洗碗巾加水，真的很好玩啊。
Whoa, that's so neat! From that topic, the students can play with the bubbles while learning some English. And content is very useful and connected to daily life.
Yeah, the students also learned about different shapes, triangle, heart, square, by making them into bubble wands that they later played with.
就用不同形状的铁线所吹出来的泡泡，不知道会不会是一样的？我猜有不同形状的用具。 会吹出不同形状的泡泡。
Using different shapes to make bubbles. Huh, this is new knowledge to me. But aren't all bubbles round? Is it correct?
You are correct. The students blew through triangle bubble wands but made round bubbles, heart bubble wands but made round bubbles, and so on. You see, learning by doing is a great teaching strategy. The students can experience it by themselves to come to the solution. In this case, all bubbles are round.
就是我们最喜欢的做中学活动了，就是用一种实际生活体验与问题的解决。在活动过程中，我们不仅可以学到英文的单字、句子以及新知识，还可以跟老师多加练习生活美语的对话呢。
Wow, how interesting! I think that's why science and DIY classes are always so popular for the students.
Yeah, oddly enough, my favorite subject in school is math. We also learned by hands-on learning, like this scale. We used it to learn balance and weight concepts, you know, heavy and light. So I like to apply this method to my teaching.
用天平来平整和了解平衡的概念，这是我们在数学课中和自然课中都会使用到的。实际动手操作过后，真的学得比较快，而且也比较容易运用在我们的日常生活中呢。
I like learning by doing too. Okay, our Shanfeng Broadcasting program is coming to an end. Thank you, Teacher Jenna. It's really great that you could share your teaching and learning methods with us.
You are most welcome. I'd just like to add I'm happy to be here. I hope all students can learn English while having fun.
没错， so
we try.
We learn.
And we show the best.
Thank you, Teacher Jenna. 谢谢您收看这集的三方早安话新闻。我是主播向少俊。
我是主播林诗晴。
下次的三方小主播我们再见了。拜拜。